Hi everyone and welcome back. Welcome to my another playlist where I will be just covering some objective questions in JavaScript. So I have like full length of videos, full length of questions which we will go through. So sometimes in coding questions they will ask you to do a test, and that test contains a 20 or 30 objective questions in JavaScript. So those questions are basically related to a scope, arrow functions, the basic concept of JavaScript, okay? So we will go through them in 10 questions a set. So one video will have a 10 questions, and this is how we will go through. We will talk about why this is the answer, why not the other one. We will talk about in depth. Okay. So here is a simple question, right? Say hi functions, and we are calling it, and now we need to write the answer of this. What should be the output? Console.log name and age you are trying to print. Name is a variable and age is a let. So you already know the difference. What is the name and age? What is the difference between var and let? It will be hoisted to the top. So console.log name should be undefined, but age is not defined at this line. So it will give me the error. So according to me, the first one should be undefined and second one should be, so answer should be D. Okay. And explanation is also same. Question 2. So question 2 is, what will be the output of this? So you already know how to write a asynchronous block inside a loop. Here we are writing a set timeout with the var keyword. So it will actually iterate. And this is actually example of closure. Closure with set timeout, right? So here we are trying to log it, and it's a var loop. So even I will increment to 3 and then set timeout will start resolving these values. So you will get a 333, but here is the let. Let provides a block level scoping. So in the closure, it will maintain each and every iteration will maintain its value of I. So here we will get 0, 1, 2, answer is C. Okay. What is the output of this? Now, another important thing is, this is about this context. Here we have a shape object. We have a radius diameter. The only difference between diameter and parameter is, this is an arrow function and this is a normal function. So we already know that whenever we use arrow function, this will start pointing to the global context. Here, this on this line, this is pointing to the shape object. Here, this dot radius is pointing, not pointing to the shape object, but the outer scope, which is a global. So this dot radius here will be not defined, because in global, we don't have a radius variable. I mean, for Node.js, it's a global. For JavaScript client, it's a window object. So it's a not a none, not a number. Undefined multiply by some number will be not a number. So parameter will be not a number. So it will be this dot radius. This dot radius is by 220 and not a number. So answer should be B. Okay. And you can also read the explanation of it, how it is happening. Now this. So this is actually a typecasting. Okay, true. You are actually trying to convert it to a number with plus. So true is already true is true, and when you convert it to a number, it should convert to 1, right? Because it specifies the true the condition. So 1, and this is true, and you are actually negating it, so it will become false. So it should be 1 and false, A. Now this, which one is true? We have the bird object, we have the mouse object. Now, if you see this, object indexes, object key, you can also access as an array indexes, like mouse, bird.size, which is a small, yes, I can access it, there is nothing wrong with this. Mouse, bird of size is small, this will give me a small, and mouse of small is, I have the value as a true. This is also valid, but this is not valid. Mouse.bird, in mouse, we don't have bird property. So this is not valid. Okay, what will be the output of this? Here you can see we created a C object, D object, D is assigned to C. So it's like a reference copy. If you are changing C dot greetings to hello, then D dot greeting will also be hello, right? So answer should be A. What will be the output of this? So here A is a number and B is also a number, object number, and C is a number. So A double equals B is fine, but A triple equals B is not fine. And B triple equals to C is also not fine. So A double equals B should be true. So it should be true, false, false. C, true, false, false. Okay, here we have a class, method, and a constructor. Okay, now we are creating the object of this class and calling this color change method. Okay, color change method we are calling, we are assigning new color and returning new color. Now let's see this. First you need to understand, you are actually calling a static method from an object. Static methods can be called directly from the class name. You don't need an object, so it should be a type error. Here, let greeting, this is undefined. We actually created a greeting which is empty object. When you are actually declaring any variable without var or let keyword, they gets added in the window object. And here greeting, same object I'm trying to print, so I think there is no issue. It will give us an object A. What happens when you do this? There is a bark, is a functions, bark.animal equal to dog. So it's same as adding some prototype property to a bark function. So I don't think any problem here. So answer should be A. Right? It is possible because functions are object and you can actually add a property to a particular function. Right? Okay, so this is the first set of questions of 10 questions. And you might see these questions here and there when you actually face some kind of objective questions in JavaScript.